the solution for this example, we're going to click here, find VLOOKUP. So the lookup value in this case is I want to look up this employee number. Where must it go look? It must go look over here. And notice that I highlight all the columns that I may want to pull through. And I go all the way to the bottom here. Very important and often forgotten is that because I'm going to copy this down and I always wanted to look at this table, I need to put dollar signs on the table array. The column index number, we've asked for the total out of office expenses, which is over here. This is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of the table array we've given it. So I'm going to put a 5 in. And in this case, we want to find an exact match. It must find that employee number and give us no other number. So we're going to put a false in here. And when we say OK, you'll see it gives us an NA. And if you look here, you'll see that you cannot find that student number. If we copy this down, you'll see that student or employee number 100135 is generating 1518. And if we look here, you'll see there's the employee number, there's the total. And so it's gone and pulled through the total expenses for each employee can find. And where it can't find the employee, it gives us an NA. The second part of the solution now is we want to check whether the list of outstanding expenses actually exists as an employee. So again, we'll do a VLOOKUP. The lookup value, we're going to say we want to look up that employee number. Where must it look up? We're going to say over here. And in this case, I'm just going to highlight one column because I don't actually care about anything else. It's either there or it's not. Again, I must remember to put dollar signs on. The column number, we've only given it one column in this table, so we can only ask for number one. And the range lookup, we want to find an exact, so it must either find that employee number or not. So we put false here, and when I say OK, you'll see it pulls back that same number. If we copy it, you'll notice that where an employee number doesn't exist, like that one there, we're shown with an NA.